Some may have perceived the MTRCB in the past as really leaning more towards movies rather than TV, because people may say, okay, movies, clear-cut, you have ratings. There's GP, there's PG, there's R13, there's R18, what have you.
Yes.
But for TV, it just seems to be parental guidance or not, right?
Yes.
And as you said, you don't really censor TV in terms of prior restraint as opposed to, let's say, movies, where you can say, even as the trailer, you can have them edit the trailer.
Right.
So how different is your role? I mean, really, how difficult is the difference in your role from monitoring the movies and monitoring TV shows, which some people may have said that it's gotten out of hand in television?
That's it nga eh. Parang it's really more dangerous when it comes to television because it's easily accessible than the movies.
Right.
In the movie, you have to watch it before they get the permit. For television, you just sometimes submit a sample episode for like a telenovela, and that will be the basis of your rating.
Is it sometimes or that's mandatory? They have to submit a sample.
That's how it is, because we don't have the manpower also to watch every single show.
Yeah.
So we also rely on the self-regulating body of the networks.
Okay.
Now, that's what I'm trying to clarify. And I'm glad you raised that point. The rating system could be somehow elitist in nature, because not everyone understands it. Like for TV, ano ba yung PG at ano ba yung G? Not all parents are really aware of it.
Right.
And like in the US, they're very specific. Let's say they'll say R, SLV, meaning R, sex, language, violence.
And that's on
TV. And
that's TV.
That's
not movies,
Dito G and PG, right?
That's it,
and then
in
the US, there's also TVF, meaning TV fantasy, V, violence.
Wow.
Because cartoons can be also, cartoons can be violent.
Mm-hmm.
So here, what we want is actually one of the first agenda that we have is to form a committee that will look into the rating system of the movie and the TV and to make it more specific, more sensitive, and easily understandable. I always said, TV reaches Ilocos until Mindanao, right? It has to be, we have cable operators now.
Right.
It has to be in the vernacular. Ilocano, Cebuano, Tagalog, English. The rating system of the general audience should be in their vernacular so that the parents can understand. So that is going to be our campaign, even for ads, how to understand the rating system once we change it to be more specific.
Okay, so will this be part and parcel of this case, or will this be taken up immediately after? If you want it, because as you said, G and PG is not enough.
It's not enough. No. Unfortunately, the resources, the manpower of the agency is so concentrated sometimes in a full-blown issue. But and we only meet really as a board once a month. And this is something that needs the board's concentration.
Right.
We want it as soon as possible. But we are looking probably a couple of weeks and hopefully a resolution of this case as soon as possible.
But would you say that what would come out of this in the details as of going through this process could help for as precedents to give you those ratings that you want to change?
It's always a study that we can consider.
Okay.
Precedents in other adjudicating cases. But for now, we really have to learn from this. Otherwise, it will really end up as a tragedy, not just for Janjan, but for the other children and the viewing public in particular. Let me make this clear that we want a speedy resolution to the case, but we also want to make sure that there's no impression that we are railroading it.
Okay.
Because the MTRCB is a very unique body that can prosecute and judge at the same time.
Right.
So there's room for abuse if you are not fair.
Mm-hmm.
So I know that other agencies are really in a hurry, and other impassioned advocates are also in a hurry, but we are being very careful that they cannot say that we didn't study this case very well.
All right, so with regards to the TV ratings that could change, so would you say you, I mean, for now, personally, your opinion, aside from the board getting into it, would you suggest something like the U.S., where in, like, I think a good 10 seconds before each program, there's a voiceover that says, this next show, as you said, is TV, LS, whatever, and they explain verbally what it is?
Yes, absolutely. You have to explain it. Because sometimes you just say GPG, what's that?
Well,
right?
That for now, if I'm not mistaken, all I hear is if it is PG, ang programang ito ay may kailangan ng patnubay ng magulang. That's
correct.
It.
Right.
And as you said, might not be understood down south.
you know, sometimes we have the flair for the being dramatic. Mm-hmm. Sometimes I think our rating system have to be as dramatic mm-hmm. as what's appealable to the public. Mm-hmm. So these are the things that we have to consider, how to effectively market mm-hmm. the rating system.
Okay.
It's not just to impose it, but to make it viable so that people okay. will understand it and mm-hmm. people will internalize it. And parents, I'm not saying that I'm passing it on to the parents, mm-hmm. but parents should be our partners mm-hmm. here.
Good point that you raised, parents should be partners, because I wanted to ask you, how can you get the public involved? As you said, you're strapped for budget, you know, you're not as big an agency as you'd like to be. You can't watch everything on television,
right.
especially now with so many cable channels coming up and about and so much content coming out. How can the public be involved and help you? Aside from this is a big issue, of course, the whole, you know, a lot of the significant amount of people in public made a public outcry and said this is too much. But on a day-to-day basis, if they see something, let's say, in a telenovela or in a game show or something, and they found it not proper, how can they get in touch with the MTRCB and say,
yes,
I saw this and this and that, you should check this out?
Oh, yes, absolutely they can. First of all, how can we get the public involved? Mm-hmm. Thankfully, mm-hmm. the group of theater owners mm-hmm. Met with us, and even some cable providers, and they said they will air ads of mm-hmm. the MTRCB mm-hmm. about any public service
okay.
ads, and we
cool.
would like that, to take that opportunity
all
to
right.
educate the public on the new rating system. They can show it in theaters, on television, for
okay.
free.
All
so
right.
it's not really an expense, and we can get actors, no politicians involved, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. just education.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and then next, your next question being, aside from how to get the public involved,
yeah. How can they get in touch with you guys?
They can get
can
in
they?
Touch with
is
us.
I mean, is this something that in the mandate of MTRCB, can you be spurred by a simple complaint of a simple Juan de la Cruz?
Yeah, Juan de la Cruz can actually file the complaint.
Wow, they can.
Yes,
file
that's
the
why
complaint.
They can file the complaint with us.
Oh, like, by the way, the office is in Timog, so you
okay.
might have people
ganito
coming there
po,
and saying,
okay.
"I will complain."
Ganito lamang po, because I don't want to alienate. I don't want to. I don't want to give unfair advantage to one sector of society.
Right,
but we have our website,
okay.
mtrcb.gov.ph,
yes.
which is very easily accessible. You can send your comments and your complaints there. You can also call us. Should I give the phone
sure,
number?
Sure, yeah.
But actually, I'm not even sure if it's the correct number. Maybe subconsciously, I don't know.
It's okay.
We'll be
we can
inundated.
Follow it up.
Okay.
Yeah, all right.
But we are in Timog Avenue.
Okay.
It's a government office.
Yep.
So you're welcome to
you
go there.
You won't miss it. It's huge. It says MTRCB.
Number
and it's
18
across
Timog Avenue.
Laugh Line, if I'm not mistaken, or something. One of those.
Across Laugh Line,
yeah.
Burger King, and Metro Bank.
There you go. Okay. Okay. So moving on. Some questions I've been monitoring on Twitter as well before I read what we have on screen. Interestingly enough, is there a rule about a first offense, second offense, third offense kind of thing that could permanently take somebody out of television? Because if I'm not mistaken, I don't know the specific history, I know Willie has been involved in some things in the past that have had shows here suspended, and he himself, I think, was suspended before. Will you be looking at that as well? As, let's say after you judge this and say this was done, oh, but by the way, you did something in the past. Could this affect the final judgment?
Unfortunately, or fortunately, perhaps, for the liberal advocates, we can't really prosecute an individual.
Okay.
Okay. And we don't have a ruling even for shows three strikes and you're out.
Walang ganon.
Walang
okay.
ganon. Walang specific.
Because laws have that, right? I mean,
right.
first offense is just a fine, second offense is a bigger fine, and third offense, you go to jail.
Parang wala naman.
Batas,
eh? Again,
yeah.
it's in the discretion of the board.
Mm, okay.
So if the board thinks that you're a repeat offender and that there could be a preventive suspension.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay. To deter you from inflicting more harm to
okay.
the public,
mm-hmm.
to the viewers. But there's no nothing that first offense, second, but of course we take precedence.
Okay. Okay, we'll go to some questions now that we have from our viewers on Twitter and Facebook. A lot of them very interesting questions. First up from Kyle. Kyle asks, what if the parental guidance rating will be replaced with a detailed TV content rating system that is targeted for certain age groups? Wow, specific, like 3 plus, 6 plus, 12 plus, and 16 plus. Is this what you were mentioning, the U.S.? Are they that specific as well? As in,
yes, they are.
Hindi lang pambata, eh. Apat na klaseng bata.
I don't know exactly how it's categorized, but I know there's TVU.